This is the International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor Facility, famously known as ITER, located in southern France. In the most concise synopsis, it aims to build a nuclear fusion reactor. But not just an ordinary fusion reactor, aside from it being the largest and most expensive science experiment ever in human history, it will be our leading step forward towards the holy grail of clean energy. To briefly explain why, fusion reactor efficiency is measured by Q number. It is the ratio between the energy input and the energy output of the reactor. The joint European torus currently holds the record of the largest Q number of 0.67, which is still far from break-even point of Q equals to 1. ITER aims to generate over 500 megawatts out of 50 megawatts of energy, which corresponds to a Q number almost greater than 10. However, one important thing worth noting is that ITER does not aim to be a commercial fusion reactor that can be attached to our grid in the future. It only aims to prove reactor design and principles for future engineers as basis. Enter DEMO. DEMO is the intermediate step between ITER and a commercial fusion reactor. DEMO, since there is very limited information yet about its actual scope, basically is going to continue testing and furnishing all information generated from ITER. And one of the further testing needed in this reactor is the concept of breeding blanket. I have found this research entitled Pre-Analysis of Water-Cooled Lithium-Lead Breeding Blanket Mock-up Neutronics Experiment in a Frascati Neutron Generator. Breeding blankets, which will not be tested in ITER, is one of the key components in developing nuclear fusion technology, and it accomplishes the functions of tritium breeding and nuclear to thermal power conversion. Now, due to numerous delays in development of ITER, the timeline for DEMO also moves, and we don't want that. Thus, breeding blanket testing is then reassigned in ITER under the ITER Test Blanket Module Program. This strategy will help DEMO to stick to its time frame as planned. What then is the problem that this research wants to address? Well, the tritium production rate in a breeding blanket must guarantee the self-sufficiency of the reactor and provide a surplus of tritium for the power plant to start up. As the BB design and performance rely on neutronics calculation, and as uncertainty in these calculations would have huge impact on tritium, it is crucial to perform experiments to check the reliability of computer simulations. This research analyzes one of the proposed module under TBM, which is the water-cooled liquid lithium lead, in a mock-up experiment to validate its perceived efficiency and possible drawbacks. What are the limitations? There are currently 6 test blanket systems to be installed in ITER under the framework of the ITER TBM program. And one of the 6 is the water-cooled lithium-lead breeding blanket. This paper specifically explored the development process and design status of WCLL test blanket module, especially on tritium breeding ratio, which was deemed crucial in providing information for the development of DEMO breeding blanket. What are then the limitations imposed? While breeding blankets play a crucial and large role in the reactor, this research only focuses on the validation of the tritium breeding ratio and the shielding capability predicted by the neutronics design calculations for the WCLL blanket. Also, the results of this mock-up experiment are derived only from a Frascati neutron generator irradiation facility and not from the DEMO reactor or ITER itself. Digging deeper into the research, the initial hypothesis is to demonstrate the representativeness of the MACUP experiment to define which materials can be used without affecting the reliability of the results compared to the demo, to evaluate the effect of the background in order to predict its impact on the measurement, and to calculate the nuclear quantities in order to assure their measurability during the experimental campaign. In the presentation of the results of the simulation of the MACUP experiment in the Frascati neutron generator, the researchers were able to successfully represent the WCLL breeding blanket in demo. This achievement allows the researchers to analyze the tritium breeding ratio of the installation without actually recreating the demo setup. At the end, this research concluded the successful representativeness of the MACUP experiment compared to the ones proposed in demo breeding blanket. This representativeness has been demonstrated in two ways. First, comparing material distribution inside demo breeding blanket with the ones inside the MACUP assembly. And second, the TPR in both cases while considering both the plasma neutron source in demo and the FNG pointwise source. Finally, for future studies, this research reportedly neglects the effect of background to the calculated nuclear quantities. Background, in the case of this research, is defined as the contribution of the neutrons scattered by the bunker walls to the calculated nuclear quantities. The results will certainly be different if these backgrounds were to be considered in calculating the nuclear quantities in this research.